Children, reading is always better than watching TV. With reading, you think, you imagine, and you use your brain. Whereas TV gives light, sound, and color effect altogether. You feel good, but sleep is far. Today's bedtime story is Forest Fun. Krisha leapt from her bed and rushed to get ready. She was watching TV till late night and now she was late. Everyone knows how hard it is to get up when you went to bed late the night. You have all your sweetest dream in the morning, especially if you have to go to school. When Krisha entered into her class breathlessly, she heard Rita ma'am announcing a surprise test and she sighed. First time late and now this surprise test. It was a bad day for Krisha again. She lost out on many things just because she was late. She was punished, she was scolded and she was shamed. She came back home with a very heavy heart and picked up her mother's mobile and started texting sad messages to her dad and other friends. Another unlucky day for me, she wrote. And lo, her spirit soared high as she started getting replies immediately. Oh, how sad. Hey, what happened? She then forgot all about the bad day and started messaging her friends joyously. Her colony friends playing in the park were one less. Three is no company, we are short of one. The game we want to play, only four is fun. And little Raghu was sent to call Krisha to join them. When Krisha saw Raghu at her door, she said quickly, "Hey, I'm busy, I'm texting." "Oh, why should you text? I thought you could always speak on mobile." Raghu was surprised. And little Krisha took a long time explaining the fun involved in sending and receiving the short messages. "Please, Krisha, come and play one game with us. Then text the whole world about it," Raghu pleaded. Krisha agreed unwillingly. The four friends played football for a long time. What fun they had! Little Krisha was at her best. She ran as hard and kicked as many goals to win for her team. It was a perfect evening and her cheeks were red in the cold air. The streams of frosted air were coming out of her mouth. And when it was time to go home, Krisha was as hungry as a wolf. Krisha was free early that night. With a game of football with her friends, she was full of energy. She had finished her homework, put her bag and changed her clothes too. She was happy, but she was not sleepy. Though she had promised her mother to sleep early the same day, but she went to her to take permission to watch television. "Come and sit with me," Mom told her. "You are going to read a lovely story from this book full of pictures." "Mom, cartoons are also stories," Krisha argued. "But with reading, you think, you imagine, and you use your brain, whereas TV gives light, sound, color, and action effect altogether. You feel good, but sleep is far," Mother explained. "Reading? Okay." Little Krisha could hardly understand what her mother said, but one thing was sure. Within 15 minutes of reading, she fell off to sleep. And so it was that every evening, Krisha sat with her mother before bedtime and read a story from the big colorful book. And each morning she did get up in time. Thank you, children. Good night. and sweet dreams.